2020, a lot of people have either purchased snowmobiles for the first time or after being out of the sport for a long time and they're rusty. If that fits your situation, then this video is for you. What we're going to talk about today is called ditch riding or ditch banging by some people. Like anything, there are risks, but snowmobiling is about managing risk, not avoiding it. What I'm going to talk to you about today is legal. It's your responsibility as a snowmobiler to know the laws and regulations and to follow them. Never assume that if I say something, then it must be legal. Always check for yourself. This video is intended to get you started, not give you all of the answers. So first, let's talk about technique, and in a few minutes we'll talk about things that will likely either ruin your day or your season and how to avoid them. Beginner's rule number one for ditch riding, and as far as your technique goes, plan on or try to go either straight up or straight down. Try to avoid angles. And how you can do that in the ditch is, you know, if you use the width of the ditch or as much room as you have, make a wide turn away from where you want to go. So you turn away from the way that you want to go, make a wide sweeping or parabolic turn so that you end up going straight up as much as possible. This is important earlier in the season when you're riding in the lowest part of the ditch, and the sides of the ditch are more extreme angles. Try never to side hill or lean uphill and ride parallel to an embankment, because what's going to happen is you're going to end up needing to go up at some point, and all of your weight is trying to counteract that 600-pound machine going down. And there's only so much your weight can do to convince a snowmobile that's already wants to go down to go up. So try to always go straight up or straight down. That'll make it a lot easier. And try not to side hill, because or ride on the edges of the embankment, because that's the most difficult. It's kind of like flying into a box canyon. You're going to end up in a situation where you cannot get out. Okay, rule number two. If you need to cross a road or get onto the shoulder, always look first. Never assume that there's nobody coming. One of the best ways to do this is, if you can, use one of those parabolic or wide sweeping turns away from the road, climb up on the opposite side, and then as you turn to go up the road ditch, the roadside of the ditch, now you can look both ways. You can also stop. So if there's somebody coming, you can afford to stop and wait there. If you stop and wait and you're already going up the other side, you've just created a situation where you're almost guaranteed to get stuck, and you're a lot better off. Start on the opposite side than where you want to go, and go down in the ditch and then up the other side while you have the momentum to do that. Rule number three, if you're faced between a situation where something looks dangerous, but the alternative to that might be illegal, manage the risk. So I can't tell you what to do, except that if you manage the risk properly, you're going to have a good day of snowmobiling and you're going to get to go home. There are times when you simply can't do what's legal. For instance, crossing maybe there's a cattle crossing where there's barbed wire fence going across the ditch, or maybe there's a stream or something that's going across the ditch. It's not safe. You might want to get up on the shoulder, but that might not be legal. Do what's best for you under those circumstances, and make that call and manage the risk. Rule number four, be respectful to landowners. There's a lot of times when you're riding in a ditch that's right next to a house. Be nice to those people in the house, because they're the ones that, you know, a lot of times they're going to be outside. There might be kids in the ditch playing. You don't know. So be careful as you go past houses. Until you get to know an area, which houses are likely to have kids in the ditch or whatever, just be careful as you're going past those houses. There's a lot of driveways and field approaches that you can jump. Pick one of those, and not the ones that are near a house. There are a lot of times ditches with drifts in the ditches, and those are fun to jump on and carve on. But always remember rule number one: try to go straight up one of those drifts or come straight down. If you try to go at an angle, invariably you're going to end up rolling off the snowmobile and getting bucked. And speaking of getting bucked off, wear your tether. So that's rule number six. Wear your tether if you have one, because if you get bucked off and that snowmobile rolls on top of you, you don't want that track spinning. Or you don't want that snowmobile rolling off into one of your buddies and not stopping. You want to be able to stop that snowmobile as soon as you fall off. Rule number seven, where there's grass, there's air. So a lot of times snow will stick to the top of you get tall grass in a ditch, the snow will stick to the top and won't fall down in between, won't get to the ground. So you end up with these situations where as you look at it, you're looking at the ditch, it looks like it's full of snow, there's all kinds of snow, you should be able to ride right down the ditch, but instead you end up literally in over your head because there was nothing but air underneath a few inches of snow. Speaking of sinking, so in that case you'll feel yourself sinking, and if you feel yourself sinking for any reason, that's a sensation that's telling you that you're about to get stuck, and the only way out of it is to power out. So apply power as soon as you feel like you're sinking, and give that engine an excuse to sink. This is one of those situations where too much power may not be enough. So don't be afraid to really give it as much gas as you want to. And don't let up until you can feel that the track is starting to catch up and get traction. Okay, that's enough of tips. Finally, some things that you need to watch out for that can ruin your day, ruin your season, or worse. The first one, and probably the most common, are culverts. There's always culverts they go under the road, they go under road approaches, field approaches, and driveways, and they're almost always at a low point. So just even if those culverts aren't marked by posts, assume that the lowest point in a ditch, there's a culvert there, and avoid that. Speaking of posts, those can be anywhere and any height. Posts can be, you know, they might be used to mark something important, or they might be broken off signposts. So you don't know, sometimes they're just barely sticking out of the snow, sometimes they're standing nice and tall. Assume that there can be posts anywhere and keep an eye out for them. Fence lines are another thing that can take you by surprise, because fence lines and barbed wire aren't always parallel to the ditch and are not always visible when you're moving. So keep an eye out. Use your peripheral vision to keep an eye out for fence posts and barbed wire, especially because those will definitely ruin your day. And they may not go parallel to the ditch. They may cross the ditch in front of you. You just never know. That's another case for taking it easy at night too, because those things will pop out of nowhere. And when you're going fast, you'll drive through a fence line, and it could potentially kill you. So be careful. There are objects in the ditch that can damage your sled, especially in low snow conditions early in late winter. Rocks, garbage, old tires, all that stuff. Be very careful and aware of that. Avoid riding at night in unfamiliar territories. I already kind of mentioned that, but save your night riding for areas where you know well. At night, car headlights make visibility very difficult in the ditch. They tend to blind you and make everything black ahead of you. Night is the time when most riders are killed. If a rider is killed, it's usually at night. Barbed wire fences, signposts. I know one guy got decapitated by a signpost because he was side-hilling and didn't see the signpost. Open water, culverts, all kinds of things. It's just a bad deal. It's better to know your area and be cautious. Ride with at least one buddy whenever possible. There's safety in numbers, and a buddy or two or three is going to help you dig faster when you get stuck, and also going to bail you out in case one of you gets into trouble, breaks down, or whatever. Start slow. The idea is start slow. Get to know the area, get to know your riding, make your, you know, work on your skills first. As you get better, as you get more comfortable with the area, you're going to have, you know, you're going to be able to go faster and you're going to have more fun. So take it easy at first, so that you can make mental notes about hazard areas and learn. Riding ditches can be a great way to snowmobile, especially early or late in the season, but also is a great place to work on your snowmobiling skills. Have fun, stay safe, and always manage the risk.